Let's stand as we worship together. Every week, the people of God gather in the place of God to experience the presence of God. And we gather as people from completely different backgrounds, but we are united in this expectation of what's about to happen. This is the start of every church service, but this experience isn't unique just to the church. In any gathering, but especially in the important ones like a wedding, dearly beloved, we are gathered here today, or the funeral. On behalf of the family, we gather here. In this coming together, there's no randomness. It's not meaningless. When people gather, they gather with something in common. So what do we have in common? Well, we are the people of God, gathered in the place of God, in the presence of God, and we are expectant to meet him here today. So as we continue, I just want to ask God to open the gates, open our hearts, and just to come and flood this space and be here with us. So let's continue to worship together.
Well, I've searched the world but it couldn't fill me. Man's empty praise and treasures of faith are never enough. Then you came along and you put me back together. And every desire is now satisfied here in your love. Oh, there's nothing better than you, Lord. There's nothing better than you, Lord. There's nothing, oh, nothing is better than you. Yes, I know it's true. Oh, I'm not afraid to show you my weakness, my failures and flaws. Lord, you've seen them all, and you still call me friend. 'Cause the God of the mountain, He's the God of the valley. And there's not a place your mercy and grace won't find me again. Oh, there's nothing better than you, Lord. There's nothing better than you, Lord. There's nothing. Oh, nothing is better than you. I know it's true. Oh, there's nothing better than you. There's nothing better than you, Lord. There's nothing. Oh, nothing is better than you. You turn mourning to dancing. You give beauty for ashes. You turn shame into glory. You're the only one who can. You turn mourning to dancing. You give beauty. Turn shame into glory. You're the only one who gets. You turn rain into garden. You turn bones into army. You turn seas into highways. You're better than you. Oh, there's nothing. Oh, nothing is better than you. I know it's true. Oh, there's nothing better than you. Oh, there's nothing better than you. Oh, there's nothing. Oh, nothing is better than you. Turn graves into gardens. You turn bones into armies. You turn seas into highways. You're the only one who cares. between us. How high the mountain I could not climb. In desperation, I turned to heaven and spoke your name into the night. Then through the darkness, your loving kindness tore through the shadows of my soul. The work is finished, the end is written. Jesus Christ, my living Lord. Who could imagine could fathom such boundless grace? The God of ages stepped down from glory to wear my sin and bear my shame. The cross has spoken, I am forgiven. The King of Kings calls me. Oh, Savior, I'm yours forever. Oh, Jesus Christ, my living.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah. Praise the one who set me free. Hallelujah. Death has lost its grip on me. You have broken every chain. Salvation in your name, Jesus Christ, my living God. Oh, hallelujah. Praise the one who set me free. Hallelujah. Death has lost its grip on me. You have broken every chain. Praise the one who set me free. Hallelujah.
We cannot overstate the importance of proclaiming the word of God in our services. Sometimes through a song, sometimes through the scriptures, and often through a message or a sermon. We hear about who God is and what God has done. Like the vows in a wedding service, God reveals his promises to us through his word. So first, we gather in his presence. And then God speaks to us to declare his love, his faithfulness, and his forgiveness. We look back in the Bible to remember all the great things that God has done to rescue his people, his mighty acts of salvation. We're invited to place our hope in him for our own lives. When we look at his stories, when we see his faithfulness, that faithfulness time and time again can begin to work at us. When we remember what he's done, that leads to hope. We remember and we hope. Remembrance and hope are themes that show up in the story of the life of Jesus. And never more prominently than in his last meal, his last supper he shared with his disciples. We emulate this today and enact that same ritual. We call this communion. And when we receive it in our church, when we take communion, we remember the story of how Jesus gave his body and his blood to save the world. He told us to eat this meal that we might place our hope in his power to save for whatever may come, now and in the future. I'm going to read from the Apostle Paul, St. Paul, in his letter to the Corinthians. And as we do this, I'll give you a moment to take communion. He says this, "On the same night the Lord Jesus was betrayed, he took the bread in his hands. After giving thanks to God, he broke it and he said, 'This is my body, broken for you. Keep doing this so that you and all who come after will have a vivid reminder of me.' You may now take the bread." After they'd finished dinner, he took the cup in the same way and said, "This cup is the new covenant, executed in my blood. Keep doing this. And whenever you drink it, you and all who come after me will have a vivid reminder of me. Every time you taste this bread, and every time you place the cup to your mouths and drink, you're declaring the Lord's death, which is the ultimate expression of his faithfulness and love until he comes again. You may take the cup and drink." Let's keep remembering and keep worshiping together today.
You can stand when you're ready.
Do you feel the world is broken? Do you feel the shadows deepen? Do you know that all the dark won't stop the light from getting through? Do you wish that you could see it all made new? Is all creation groaning? Is a new creation coming? Is the glory of the Lord to be the light within our midst? Is it good that we remind ourselves of this? Judah, they conquered the grave. I've seen what you can do, oh God of wonders. Your power has no end. The things you've done before, in greater measure, you will do again. There's no prison wall you can't break through, no mountain you can move, all things are possible. There's no broken body you can raise, no soul that you can save, all things are possible. The darkest night, you can light it up, oh, you can light it up. Oh God of revival, let over eyes, death is overcome. Oh, you've already won. Oh God of revival, you rose in victory, and now you're seated forever on your throne. So why should my heart fear what you defeated? I will trust in you alone. There's no prison wall you can't break through, no mountain you can't move, all things are possible. There's no broken body you can't raise, no so then you can save, all things are possible. The darkest night, you can light it up, oh, you can light it up. Oh, God of revival, let hope rise, death is overcome, oh, you've already. Awaken your people. Come awaken the people. Come awaken the city. The God of revival, pour it out, pour it out. Every stronghold will crumble. I hear the chains hit the ground. The God of revival, pour it out, pour it out. Come awaken your people, come awaken the city. Oh God of revival, pour it out, pour it out. Every song on the combo, I hear the chains in the ground. Oh God of revival, pour it out, pour it out. Oh, Oh, you can break through no mountain, you can move, all things are possible. There's no broken body you can raise, no soul that you can save. All things are possible, all things are possible. Thank you, guys. You can go ahead and have a seat.
Often toward the end of a message or a service, we're given the opportunity to respond to God's word. For many of us and many of you, that was the moment when we first made a decision to follow Jesus. But there are other ways that we respond as well, like through communion, which we practiced a moment ago. Also through the sacrament of baptism, which we're going to experience in just a moment. Responding to God through baptism is a lot like the moment in a wedding ceremony when the bride and groom respond by saying, "I do." They say, "I do," for the benefit of each other, but the whole wedding party has a participatory role and they share in the experience. Baptism is a public declaration that all would see and know you've made the decision to live a life in a relationship to God. As we baptize people, join with me in celebrating each person as they say, "I do," and publicly commit to all of us what they've committed to God in their hearts.
But today I have Alex patiently waiting for me. I've known Alex for about a year and a half, maybe. How long have you been here at Fountain Springs? And he's been very faithful member of our downtown community here. I've seen him join a group, lead a group. He serves. He's probably a smiling face you see every second week when you walk in the door. He's such a great guy to have around, and I'm so excited that you're getting baptized tonight, Alex. It's been a privilege to see what God's doing in your life this past year, and I know this is just the beginning of what he's going to keep doing. So, Alex, I have two questions for you. The first one is, have you asked Jesus to forgive your sins? Yes. You intend to follow him for the rest of your life? Yes. Well then, Alex, once I put my watch on waterproof mode, it's my privilege to baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, buried in the likeness of his death, and raised in the likeness of his resurrection.
What a joy. We have experienced so many different ways to worship today together, communion and baptism and singing. And one other way that we can worship our God is in obedience with our finances. And we just want to give you that opportunity to do that now. It is easy and it is secure and it is such a joy to give. So we just want to present that opportunity. But I want to invite you to stand as we sing one last song together. Jesus, and I know this heart needs healing. So from my knees I lift this prayer to you, my Savior. For my life and for the world, you're the answer, Jesus. Amen.
Well, the end of our service, it might seem like a formality at times, but it's actually a lot more than that. The end of a service is, if you think about when a couple gets married and then the wedding party sends the bride and groom off and everyone cheers, well, that's the end of the wedding, but it's just the beginning of their life together. When Christy and I get married, someone wrote us a card, and it was a weird note at first, but then as I thought about it, they said, "May today be the day you love each other the least, and our love will continue to grow." So may our service be the day this week where you love and experience God the least. In the words of Jesus, let's go and make disciples and immerse them in our triune God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. You are dismissed and sent out.
Digital and consistent giving has never been easier. It's as easy as sending a text from your phone. Simply pull out your phone and text the word GIVE to 605-299-8374. It's as simple as that. Thanks for helping us make a lasting impact in the Black Hills. Here at Fountain Springs, we believe in the next generation. We want you to know that we've made it easy for your kids to engage in a service that meets them at their level. There are three easy steps to take to access these services. Step one, download our app. Launch your preferred app store and search for Fountain Springs Church. Step two, once you find it, download and open the app. Step three, on the front page, you will see an icon titled Kids Services. Just touch that image and pick the service for your appropriate age group. We have a service designed for preschool kids and a service designed for elementary kids. It's as easy as that. We hope your kids enjoy.